Japan, both very strong nations.
Will be very spectacular, John, will be a very spectacular bout. Will be very spectacular and very open. But the Browns, you know, they know it's not that much pressure, not much pressure as the gold, for the gold medal. And of course, they will let it go.
Yeah.
Better when you go for a bronze than a gold.
Sure.
Because those guys, as I say,
Takahashi and Rahimi.
Rahimi was world champion last year.
Of course.
So for him, you know, he almost lost his competition. But you know, some kind of second price, I would say.
Absolutely.
So I think he will deliver a good bout. And we saw the progress of the Iranian in freestyle, and Greg Goldman too, but in freestyle, since the last World Cup in Los Angeles, they are dominating a lot of the competition. Of course, here he lost for the gold, but you know, he's still a very important athlete and a very powerful athlete. You will see a little bit different of morphology. The Japanese guy is a little bit taller than the Iranian. So they will probably go attack the legs with the arms, because when you say they can attack legs and arms, upper body and bottom, you can attack the upper body with the bottom, but also you can attack the body, the bottom body with the upper body. So it will see on a sport on the floor, it's more spectacular sometimes, because you can think the action is finished and it's never finished.
Well, they have started here. They're underway in the first round. This for the bronze medal. Takahashi, as Danielle says, the taller of the two in red, just poking the finger in the eye there of the Iranian Rahimi. Unintentional, but it still stings nonetheless. The referee, sharp eye, protecting the athlete's safety straight away. And as you said, the taller of the two, trying to present a very small target at the moment. And there's a slap to the head there from Rahimi. Yeah. He means business.
Yes, and trying, you know, he's trying to divert the opponent with his arm here. And to make him reacting on the top. So is the time for him to attack the legs. He's making the timing like that, you know.
Absolutely, changing the timing.
Then after that, he will dive to the legs, probably.
Yep, the referee just saying a little bit of passivity here. The first warning, as Danielle mentioned, will be an official warning that's going to come up now. That is the first warning. If there's one more of them, there'll be 30 seconds on the clock. It will be the obligation of the passive wrestler to score. So it gets them going a little bit. And as you mentioned before, Danielle, the first round is just about observation, trying to find some information.
Yeah, we're already 1 minute, 50 seconds past. And it's a three-minute period of 3 minutes, so a full-time action. So they stop the clock when the referee is wrestling. They stop the clock, and they start the clock when the referee is wrestling again. So it's a full-time action for the 3 minutes. And here, it's half of the time already passed,
exactly.
And there's no action.
And the referee is about to step in. Yeah. As just you've said that, Danielle, too much passivity. And a little bit of clashing of the heads as well from Rahimi. The Iranian coach, of course, pumped up, ready for this one. If you've been in a World Championship final, you know what it's all about. But he knows about it now, Rahimi. He has that 30-second clock against his name. The Iranian in blue must now score a point. Otherwise, Takahashi will take a useful little score. But he's got the leg, Danielle.
Yeah, but you see how fast the Japanese reacting.
Good
trying
defense.
To have a crushed hip. But the Iranian is controlling the Japanese legs under himself.
Just so, 4 seconds left.
So it's no way for the Iranian to make action. So it's going to be anyway 2 points, maybe 1 or 2 points for Takahashi. They give him one.
Yep, the 1 point for failing to score by the Iranian. So the obligation now all on Rahimi. He has that World Championship crown under his belt. He's going for a bronze here. He's in a little bit of trouble, and he's poked the eye again there of Takahashi. A little bit of rough stuff from both.
But it's a little bit disappointing what we see from Rahimi, because, you know, being a world champion last year and doing that poor exhibition,
sure.
It's a little bit disappointing.
Absolutely, but the man who'll be the happiest at the moment is Takahashi, but it can change in an instant. The Japanese athlete in red trying to go on the attack there. Good defensive work from Rahimi, and just bringing it back to the centre of the mat.
And you know, as the rule changed, we had a three period of 2 minutes, and was the winner of two of three periods was the winner. Here is the cumulative, the accumulation of points, and it's a good attack from the Iranian, but he dived with his head on the floor.
And I think he's going to run out of time.
It doesn't help him. And the Japanese have a good control on the top.
For Hassan Rahimi, Daniel, there, just a little bit of a disappointing opening for him. Get warned a couple of times for using the head, warned a couple of times for linking the fingers. He's not found his rhythm just yet.
And he's not making a chain of moves, you know. He's attacking the leg, but he gets stuck in this position. Normally, he should turn around, trying to succeed to pass behind his opponent. And at the time, he will score 2 points, not one, because we gave them 1 point to the Japanese, because the Iranian didn't make any action, didn't produce any action. But if he produced an action to take a takedown, the rule changed. It was 1 point before, now it's 2 points.
Well, Takahashi has the ascendancy at the moment. He's got 3 minutes now to try and aim for the bronze medal. The centre referee just making sure that the coaches are sitting down. Etiquette maintained. The reigning coach making sure that Rahimi is up for this one.
That's the first bar to open the ball for the World Championship. That's a new attack. But you see the head of the Iranian. Now, if he raises his head, he will maybe score a point on Japanese. You have to raise his head behind, that's it. You know, he pushed with the neck, now he got 2 points.
Yep, the 2 point takedown, he made his way around the back, forced Takahashi to the mat. And he's showing his form now. He's got the gut range potential here, Daniel.
Yeah, you know the techniques, John. So he tried gut range, means, you know, taking the belt and turning the guy over on top of him and trying to obligate him to bridge. Because we know the finality of wrestling is the pin, the two shoulders touching the mat at the same time. And with that gut wrench, you make the body of the opponent oriented to the floor, the shoulders oriented to the floor, and every time he scores 2 points. And of course, from that, you can try to pin the opponent. Most of the time, they try to score points. And you see one point for the
passivity warning again.
Yeah. 1 point
for the referee, very much involved. Takahashi complaining that he's been poked in the eye on a few occasions. Whether Rahimi means it or not, it still hurts, no question about it. And the medical officers involved here, just checking on them. Some blood coming from the mouth of the Iranian. And as I mentioned, unintentional, but it still stings. Yeah. And of course, these guys have had... This is not the first match for them today.
Oh, no. No. They have 4 or 5 bouts for all the day. So if they start in the morning, it was, you know... They have to qualify, then they have to the quarterfinals, the semifinals. So it depends the number. If you have more than 16 people,
sure,
you have 16 of finals too.
Well, it's been a long day.
Yes,
it's been a long day for these two men. And they're within touching distance now of the first World Championship medal here in Tashkent at the World Championship. Another slap to the face there from Rahimi to Takahashi. It's a bit more roughhousing than wrestling. That's a full right hand to the jaw there. And the referee...
Oh, yeah. He's going to be cautioned if he continues.
And that was a mistake from Rahimi, because as you can see on the scoreboard, there's two yellow dots next to Rahimi. He was the last man to score. So technically, he's in the lead at the moment, even though it's 2-2. But Rahimi just getting a little bit too rough for the referee's liking.
But, you know, the coach are giving him advisement. They don't have the right to do that.
Sure.
When he's a time injury.
And Takahashi accepting the apology there of Rahimi. Maybe just milking it a little bit there so that the referee knows.
Yeah, the referee is giving advisement to Rahimi. No more.
It's evenly matched here. Straight for the leg there, but produces a takedown instead. Takahashi, can he get the gut wrench? Can he turn 2-4?
No way. A good defense from the Iranian. Rahimi stay flat on the stomach. So Takahashi can't turn him, but he don't insist because, you know, trying to gut wrench the other one when turning over, he put him in a bridging situation too, so it's a danger for him. 4-2, it's enough for him to win. He's still 1 minute and a half on the bout, so he don't want to take any risk now. He will fake the attacks, but he will let the Iranian to attack.
The obligation now on Rahimi to try and do something, to try and change the angle of attack. He's been very static at the moment. Good defensive work from Takahashi. And as you said, Daniel, he has to avoid the shooting for the leg here.
That should be a move. It should be points for that.
And that evens it up. Four points each. And he's in position now, Rahimi. He's got a minute left. The Uzbek crowd giving some support to the Iranians. Leg lace there, but...
Again, that's a habit, you know, a bad habit to put his fingers or his hand on the face of his opponent.
Yep. Rahimi has drawn himself to the attention of the referee on a few occasions. He's got the leg of Takahashi.
A good attack again, with score points, probably 2 points. So I think it's almost over for the Japanese guy, you know, he don't insist that much. And you can see the sweating board.
Absolutely.
They're 57 kilos and they're sweating a lot because it's very hot here, it's very warm on this hall here.
Yep, the heat is on Rahimi just now. He's got a bronze medal just in his grasp. He's grabbed onto Takahashi. Can he kill the clock? Can he get out of this position?
Yes, more than that.
Perfect.
He makes the Japanese stepping out of the limit of the combat zone, so he's got one more point.
Well, he's 3 points to the good. 10 seconds or so left. Can he hang on and grab a bronze medal to add to his world championship crown from last year? Takahashi trying to attack, but good defensive work from Rahimi.
He's trying the impossible, really. But...
Well, Rahimi made it impossible there. Good defensive work from the Iranian. He scored when he needed to, and he takes the World Championship bronze medal. That young man, Takahashi, obviously disappointed. He was leading for a long time, Daniel, but the experience of Rahimi there
told
in the end.
Yeah, he told on the mat. His experience told on the mat. And he took the risk, by the way, you know. He's shooting the legs perfectly well. Then he collects the position of his head, and it was the key moment, because at the time he can turn and score and go behind the Takahashi. So that was there are simple techniques, but you know, if they don't make fully perfect, you know, it doesn't go on that level of competition.
Well, Hassan Rahimi, great risk and great reward. A wonderful bronze medal for the man from Tehran there.
And he's very tired. You can see, exhausted, you know, after only 2 times 3 minutes.